He completed his BA at Harvard College. After serving as an Army officer in the Pacific during World War II in a unit that assembled landing craft, he worked in New York City as a welder and tugboat crewman. He returned to Harvard and earned his graduate degree in landscape architecture in 1951. He designed playgrounds and parks in Sweden, Philadelphia, and New York City, which was his home until the 1970s.
This
structure is a model of a playground. He designed a lot of beautiful, well, he's an architect, kind of artistic guy, beautiful structures for kids to play on. And this, as a full-scale model, it's, 15 feet in the air with tires hanging off on chains and kids swinging from them. I have some nice pictures. He had started writing plays in other genre during the war and continued through the 1950s until, in 1961, he co-founded the Judson Poets Theater, which laid the foundation for Off-Off Broadway. He also took a flatbed truck around the city and performed his political plays for the public. From this involvement in poor neighborhoods through his street plays, he began to apply his playground and public space ideas to the Lower East Side of Manhattan. He worked with the Puerto Rican community to make usable space in their municipally neglected neighborhoods, and that's one of these things. And they would build it. So he had a construction company of kids who actually ran an apartment building.
Right.
And they had,
Puerto Rican kids.
And he helped them do that. And they stole all his tools, but they got good with tools. And he didn't mind at all. In 1972, he founded Avanza, a construction company and a basketball team, to provide city teenagers with skills and community at a time when New York City was going bankrupt and slumlords were abandoning and burning buildings for insurance gain. This company and team put up the first windmills and solar collectors in the Lower East Side. Here it says New York City. And with these teenagers, he designed and built parks and playgrounds out of found and recycled materials. In the mid-1970s, he moved to Vermont with his wife and began to farm, while continuing to write fiction, literary criticism, and essays on economics. He also became active in his agricultural community. He was very, very connected to the dairy farmers. They all knew him, and as each one went out of business, they continued to know him. For over 50 years, he took part in many nonviolent direct actions to protest the Vietnam War, and later Vermont Yankee and Seabrook nuclear power plants. His work with other anti-war, anti-nuclear, and conservation organizations in New England, such as the Northeast Organic Farmers Association, the Institute for Social Ecology, the Ompompanoosuc Affinity Group, and Clamshell Alliance, was a passion he shared with his wife, Grace, for many years. Their company, Glad Day Publishing Collaborative, published the work of nearly a dozen authors during the late 90s. He said, "The aim of Glad Day is the restoration of a political literature."
A week ago, your breaths were shallow, the door ajar. Today, the cat sits on my lap, purring, the door shut. She kept her seat warm for me. She kept your seat warm for me. Oh, Lady Gray, keep purring. I will add that sound to the sound of the wind coming up the hill through the trees when I listen for you.
I learned to know Bob in the, I believe, in the winter of 61, 62. I came to the States in June, and during that winter, the War Resisters League and the Living Theater prepared the first general strike for peace, with which Bob was deeply involved, and I did a dance for that at Judson called a Dance of Death, and I learned to know Bob at that occasion, and we have been friends, I guess, ever since, sometimes enemies. He was a very up-and-down person, very passionate, very radical in his behavior, often very abrupt, but he was such an... I couldn't believe that he would die with his red cheeks and his wood chopping up till the last little bit of his life. He looked like he would never go away. I want to do a kind of story that was clear about one of his poems. So this poem is called Father and Son on the Road. So Duncan, listen up, right? Father and Son on the Road. On the road. The man who suddenly sang in a deep voice. Suddenly found himself singing in a deep voice.
Found himself singing
in a deep voice. In a full, unstopped voice.
In a full, unstopped voice.
As they drove down the road. This is down the road. His son beside him.
His son.
Who always said, stop, Daddy, don't sing. Stop, Daddy, don't sing. He now said, sing.
Sing.
Go on singing. Din dun, din dun, din dun, da 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 da. And he sang in his new voice, in his new found, profound, basso voice, as the sun was allowed to steer the car.
To steer the car
for the first time. The five-year-old Duncan. Which he found he could do easily, holding onto the steering wheel with both hands at his father's knee. Can't see the knee, but you can see the steering wheel. As his father sang loudly,
loudly,
then graduated to working the accelerator pedal
with his feet.
And shifting gears.
Shifting gears going uphill.
Which he found he could do easily. As his father sang deeply and profoundly in his new voice. Ha la 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 la.
Songs.
Arias.
Arias medleys.
Which he had never
been able to remember.
Never. Or sing right. As the sun steered and shifted gears when necessary.
And occasionally
made minor repairs on the car. That must be a light. The sun.
Jumping out on the road to fix the pump, the air intake, the distributor in a small way.
While his father was singing da 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 da. And to make a small clutch adjustment. While his father was singing deeply and meaningfully.
And meaningfully. Ballads.
Chanties.
Snatches of popular operettas.
Hymns.
And school anthems.
Marches.
Arias. Cantatas.
Dolce et forte. Tutte et maximum forte et vivace.
In his new voice.
Ha, ya, 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 ya. While his son went on steering and repairing the automobile. Let's see, Pete, if there's more here. Yes. There you see it. It's clearly Duncan there.
That's Bob,
and
the other guy.
That's Bob blasting out his arias.
A living likeness.
Gradually mastering the whole thing.
It came to the boy naturally.
It was simply normal.
Normal bro. windows open to every American
from birth.
From birth, as we will demonstrate here. That's how boys are born in America. So. While his father was singing, went on singing, while his father went on miraculously.
Miraculously singing.
Yeah, 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 yeah. One of Bob's many, many poems.